Okay, good morning everyone. Now I want to continue from chapter 5, lesson 10, the integrals numerically by Simpson's rule. Yeah, so on the previous lesson, I have explained to you how to approach a value of definite integral by Simpson's rule. I also reviewed about how to find the approximation value of the definite integral by Riemann sum and by trapezoid methods, and now you know how to do it by Simpson's rule. So basically there are three methods that is commonly used to approximate the value of definite integrals. Yeah, so as far as this lesson go, I have given a lot of example where you have to approximate the value of definite integrals when the function is given algebraically. Yeah, when the function is given algebraically. For example, sine x over x, and then like on your homework that I gave on the previous meeting, it's all equation that's given algebraically. Now the problem is, sometimes in the real world, you cannot really have the equation, but what you have is the table of data, like on your book page 255. Yeah, later on there will be so many implications, like for example velocity problem on your book page 257. There's a velocity problem, the table is given, which is time and speed, and then there is the spleen mass problem about the disease, to find the volume, and then also there is like an engineering, there is a tensile strength test problem number 13, page 258, where the data is given instead of the equation. So you need to be able to use these three methods to approximate the value of the definite integral, which is the product of x and y, the product of x and y, or the area below the graph. Okay, so let's use example 2 on page 255 as the example. So x and y is given, and then there are a lot of values, 30, 35, and then 40, and then so on until 70. And then here is 83, 79, 74, until 33. And of course, you don't know what kind of function this is. Yeah, the description doesn't tell you what kind of case this is. So it's just a random data point given by your book as an example. Yeah, and basically you want to find the integral from 30 until 70 of y dx. Yeah, basically this is finding the area below the graph. Or basically it's finding the product of x and y in between x equals 30 and x equals 70. Yeah, so if the data is given like that, then the factor multiplier is really important for you to know. Yeah, remember the factor multiplier. The factor multiplier for Riemann sum, three, then trapezoid, and then Simpson. Yeah, the factor multiplier is always 1 1 1 1 1 1, and then the trapezoid multiplier is always 1 2 2 2 2 1, and then the Simpson rule is always 1 4 2 4 2 2 4 1. Okay, so for example, the solution given in your book page 255, it's using Simpson's rule. So there is the x and there is the y, and then the factor means the factor that we use is the Simpson's rule, because it's asked to use Simpson's rule to approximate the value of the integral. Yeah, so it means that the area is approximated by 1 over 3 delta x, and then the sigma here, right? The sigma following the factor. Okay, now in this case what's the delta x? Then of course it's clear that the delta x is 5, yeah. Of course it's clear that the delta x is 5, so it's 1 over 3 times 5 times, now the table will help you, like I said, that's why I asked you to create a table on the previous warm up and also on the quiz, because it will help you numerically to see the sum and it's easier to calculate. Yeah, you see there is the column x, there is the column y, there is a column factor 1 4 2 4 2 4 2 4 1, and then y times factor. And if you use the trapezoid, of course the factor can be changed into 1 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 1, and if it's Riemann sum then the factor can be changed to just 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. Yeah, so basically it's multiplied by 1368, which is equal to 5 of yeah, it's about 2280. Yeah, so that's how you approach, that's how you find the approximation value of definite integral using Riemann sum, using trapezoid, and using Simpson's rule. Yeah, and be careful with the delta x. Be careful with the delta x. And of course, the coefficient 1 over 3 is for Simpson, half is for trapezoid, and 1 is for Riemann sum. So that's all for this lesson. Thank you.